Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, and as always, thanks for watching. So we need to have a conversation. If you're like me and you're using these to store everything on, oof, we got issues. Let's talk about it. Real quick, before we get into the video, if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet and you want to learn more about what it takes to make YouTube videos, gear reviews that'll help you along the way, tips and tricks and tutorials and all that good stuff when it comes to photography and filmmaking, make sure you subscribe and hit the bell to be notified when I post my next video. Like I said, if you're using external drives, we need to have a conversation. I mean, right now, that's what I use. Everything I do lives off this hard drive. I mean, it's the hard drive I work off of. It stores absolutely everything. And there's a few problems with that. It's got all my client work. It's got all my YouTube footage. It's got photos from the past few years. If I were to lose that, drop it, if the disk failed, whew, I'd have problems. I don't even want to think about it. And then if I wanted to back that up, you know, I would need a hard drive and then maybe another one and maybe another one. And then working off hard drives like that, it just slows down your workflow and they're slow to begin with. So what's the solution? I'm gonna start using this LaCie 2big Dock RAID system. If you don't know what RAID is, let me explain it, but I need visual aids. Okay, so when we're talking about data, all your data is binary code, which is ones and zeros, just a ton of ones and zeros, random numbers, all right? So like this. Now with a RAID system, this one in particular, you can do RAID 0 or RAID 1. Let me explain RAID 0. RAID 0, you're gonna get the best speed, which means you got two drives in that unit and it's gonna split up your data. So it's gonna put, you know, a 0 in the first drive, a 1 in the next drive, then the next number, and you're gonna get all this crisscross. Something kind of like this. I know it's kind of confusing to look at, but you're gonna get this 0 going to this drive, this 1 going to that drive. So it splits up your data, which means you got two drives working for you and it really speeds up your workflow. It's great, but then nothing's backed up. That's where RAID 1 comes in. Let me show you. So again, you know, just random numbers, binary code for all your data. I know this is a little boring, but bear with me. And then we got our two drives. Now, with RAID 1, it's gonna back up everything. It's gonna put all that data on each drive instead of splitting it up. So all these numbers are gonna go to each drive separately. Why that helps you, you don't get the speed benefit, but you get the redundancy. So you got all your data living on each drive. So if one drive were to fail, that's okay. You got everything backed up to the next drive. So that essentially, in layman's terms, is RAID. So to sum it up, RAID 0, you're gonna get speed benefit. It's gonna break up all your data between the two drives, which is great, but I want some redundancy. So I'm gonna be using RAID 1. So all my data will be living on each drive. So if one fails, I can swap it out, get a new one, and I still have all the data backed up on the other drive. This also does what I think is called JBOD. I don't even know if I'm saying that right. So if I'm not, sorry, but it stands for just a bunch of drives and you can use each drive independently and store different data on each drive. We're not gonna be using it for that. I'm gonna be using RAID 1 because I want that insurance, that peace of mind, knowing that if one drive were to fail, I got all my data on the other drive. And this is just an initial setup. I'm gonna do what's called a NAS system, which is a network attached storage eventually, where I can have all my data living on this and then another RAID system offsite. But anyway, let's not get ahead of ourselves. Let's unbox this LaCie 2big Dock and see what it comes with and set it up. All right, let's do this. Let's talk a little bit about the LaCie 2big Dock as we unbox it. This is the Thunderbolt 3 version. So you can actually daisy chain a bunch of these together. It's also got USB 3.1 and it's also a docking station. So I can hook up external drives. I can put a compact flash card in here. I can put my SD card straight into here instead of using a bunch of dongles for my Mac. The drives are really high class drives. They're enterprise drives. They have 440 megabytes per second read and write speed. So just really fast. Let's see what comes in this. So we have the drive itself. And then this looks like all our cables. And that's it. So let's set this aside and see what cables we get. Got user manuals, warranty stuff. Great thing about this warranty is if all the drives fail, you can send it into LaCie, and this has a 5-year warranty. So if these fail within 5 years and you can't read anything, you can actually send it to them and they'll try to recover all your data, which is awesome. All right, so we have, oh wow, we got a lot of power cables. I mean, that's awesome. I don't need all these, but I guess if I were to move to a different country, I'd be covered. Anyway, so you have all your power cables. We got, looks like USB type A to USB-C cable. This is the US power, so we'll be using that one. Got our Thunderbolt 3 cable. So I read about this. This is a really short cable. Unless your computer was like right next to the dock, this cable's basically useless. So I picked up an Apple one that's longer. And what else? The power brick. That's a little big, but I mean, you need to power it up, right? Did a really good job with the packaging. Okay, yeah, man, this thing is heavy, but it's nice. I mean, you can get some units that are a little less expensive, but they're not gonna be as nice, they're gonna be really loud, and then they're not gonna have all the docking stations. I really like that because I am so sick of using dongles all the time for SD cards, for hard drives, I mean, to plug into my monitor. So this is a great option because it actually works as a docking station as well. So you can plug in an SD card, a compact flash, which I don't use Canon or anything. I don't have any cameras that use compact flash, but if you do, you got that. And then for extra storage, you can hook up another hard drive, which I'm gonna do to back up this unit for now, which is pretty cool. And then in the back, we got the fan. We got our dual Thunderbolt 3 ports, so you can actually daisy chain this together with, I think, up to like 4 units. So you can really have a lot of storage. And you got a display port and then your USB type 3 as well. So that's basically it. Let's see how we open this sucker up. So these come with Seagate Iron Wolf drives, which are just top of the line enterprise class drives. They are super, super fast. I mean, these are gonna be a lot faster than any portable hard drive, unless you're working off an SSD drive, which we'll get into in another video down the road. But these are gonna be really fast to work off of and super reliable. So with their software, I'll be able to configure this into RAID 1, so everything's backed up between the two drives. There's another drive here. There we go. So there's the second drive. So RAID 1, and then also that software will let you know if a drive is failing, so you can power it down and swap it out if you need to. So that's the LaCie 2big docking station and RAID system. I look forward to setting this up. I think it's gonna be a good solution for storing all my data. That's an unboxing and look at the LaCie 2big RAID system. I think it's really gonna fit my needs. Let me know in the comment section how you back up all your data. Are you using a RAID system? Do you want to use a RAID system? Are you using multiple drives? Anyway, I hope that gives you a really good kind of first look at this system, answered some questions about RAID that you might have. I did the best of my ability because I'm not like a computer expert. I do filmmaking and photography, but I needed something to back up all my data, so I think this is gonna work. If you found this video helpful and interesting, make sure you give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe, and then hey, if you like this video, watch one more. All right, I'll see you in the next video.